welcome to Loggery. I hope all of you are doing fine and the prep is going good. I hope you have subscribed to Loggery's YouTube channel. If you haven't, then please pause this video and subscribe to Loggery's YouTube channel. And also hit that bell notification on so that next time we upload a video, you get the notification immediately. अगर आप ये वीडियो हिंदी में देखना चाहते हैं तो नीचे दिए गए लिंक पर क्लिक करें, आपको ये वीडियो हिंदी में सुनने को मिलेगा. अगर आप ये वीडियो इंग्लिश में देखना चाहते हैं, if you want to keep on watching this video in English, then obviously keep on watching this very video. Today we are going to talk about how to prepare for GK. This is a very important and it's going to be really, really helpful video. I've broken down this video into various steps wherein I'll discuss that what are the things that you should do so that you are 101% prepared for Clat GK.
How to prepare for GK. Step 1 is reading newspapers every day. Guys, it is the most important thing. Treat your newspaper as the Bible, as your book that you have to read every day. Every day you have to sit down and read the newspaper, because it is not only your GK, your current affairs, which are dealt by the newspaper. It is your legal reasoning, questions of legal reasoning, then your English, then your reading speed is required to attempt passages, then you need to have a good comprehending techniques with you. You need to comprehend passages, you need to have the analyzing ability, quickly analyzing the reading things, the passages. So all this comes from the newspaper. Gone are the days when you could pick up Pratyogita Darpan or Coaching Institute notes and clear the GK section or clear CLAT. Now it's all about the newspaper. So I cannot talk more about reading newspaper. I hope you understand why I'm saying it. Now, reading important news, obviously you will be finding out important news, and you have to read the editorial section. Now, why editorial section is important? First things first, it is important because now the passages are being picked up from the editorial and the opinion sections of various newspapers, especially the Hindu, the Economic Times, and from the various magazines. They are the opinions of the journalists or the authors, right? So might be you have the same paragraph or the same passage out there, or you also get to handle, you know, those passages, those kind of writings, you know, how people write and how to comprehend them, how to analyze them. So that is why it is very important. And secondly, when you are new to newspapers, now there are kids who might be reading newspapers ever since, but there are people, there are candidates who are going to pick up newspapers for the first time, read them, and they won't know which news is important for them. They might think every news is important. Well, that's not the case. I'm going to make a video wherein I'm going to discuss how to find out the important news. I'm going to do that video, and you'll find the link to that video in the description box below for sure. But from the editorial section, you get to know what is the important news, because the discussion is all about the burning topic. The most important topic is there in the editorial. So you get to know that, yes, this is important. I have to conduct my research about this topic, right? Now, the newspapers that I would recommend is obviously the Hindu and the Economic Times. But if you're a beginner and you find that the Hindu is not that you are able to read, then you can go for the Indian Express and the Economic Times. Now, the Hindu and the Economic Times are the newspapers which have been recommended by the CLAT website. So you can see how important it is. Now, the tip out here is please don't collect the newspapers. Now, this mistake a lot of people make, that is to collect newspapers. Now, they think, okay, I don't have time today, I'll read it today, then day after tomorrow. And then you have 6 to 7 newspapers all piled up. Then you don't read. So please take out time, fix the time when you read the newspaper, when you make the notes. It is very important. Step 2, researching in detail about important news. Now, don't be afraid. I'll be teaching you, I'll be telling you the methods to research about the important news. You need to be a curious lawyer. Now, you need to be that 3-year-old kid whose mother is all done with that kid, because that kid is too curious, has all the questions, why, how, where, when. You need to be that kid. You need to be a lawyer who researches, who is curious to know about the news. Think of questions that are related to India, about that particular news piece and that particular news in the past, and conduct a detailed background study.
Let's see how to conduct the research. Once you have come across a piece of news
an event in the newspaper which you think is important, how to conduct a research on that. For example, there is an important news event which is there in the newspaper, you found it, right? Now, we will apply this formula. Let's call this formula CCPILO. Remember this word, CCPILO, whatever the way you want to remember it. Now, what is CCPILO formula? Once you see an important news, you are going to think about it. What are these? Cause and consequences of that particular news and event. Remember this. Then, persons or any event related to the important news event. You need to know about that person. So, CC stands for cause and consequences. P stands for any person related to the event. I stands for Indian context. Right? I stands for Indian context. L stands for law or legal significance. Any law related thing to that news or event. And O stands for any other thing. Right? O stands for basically any other question that you can think about. And if it is a law, if it is an award or recognition to which is given to a person, then you need to know in detail, in depth about that person who is receiving the award, and also about the award, that why it is given and stuff like that. So this is what you need to remember. Remember it. We are going to call it like this: CCPILO. CC stands for cause and consequences. P stands for person or people. I stands for Indian context. And L stands for in law or legal significance. O stands for any other. Now that is what you need to remember. Make a note of this. If you are making notes, then you need to think of this. You see an important news and event thing, you note down whatever is there from the newspaper, and then when you move to the internet to conduct a deep research, you're going to remember this CCPILO, that what is the cause and consequences, persons, law, Indian context, and if it's an award, then you need to conduct a detailed study about that person. I hope you get it. Now we are going to, I'm going to help you solve some illustrations that I have created to make you understand this formula much more. Let's see. For example, news about COVID-19, that is coronavirus. Okay. Now we'll be applying CCPILO formula to this very topic. Now you read a news about COVID-19, which is very common. If you see the 2020 newspapers of January, February, March, April, you see this news every day. Now, you have to conduct a detailed study about COVID-19. Now, you say which country and which city it started in. If you have to see the cause, okay, you can, you know, relate the cause to which city or country it started in. Okay, what is the cause of it? How it started? What is the story behind it? Who was the first person who got infected through it? Now the cause related questions can be this, okay? You can think of many more. Consequences, number of countries which have been affected, the worst affected countries, China or Italy, which is the worst affected country. Then the person, is there any new research or invention related to COVID-19? Who invented the first kit in India, right? Who invented the kit at the world level? Were there any other research which was conducted? There's so many researches which are being conducted. See the important researches related to COVID-19 and the persons who are related to it. Any important person who died of COVID-19 or who got affected with COVID-19, that can be a thing. Then in Indian context, which was the first case, or how many deaths took place, how many people were affected, which was the worst city, which was legal. So you need to see it in the legal context. Is there any law passed? Is there anything related to COVID-19? And is there any law passed related to COVID-19? There are various states have passed laws. What was done by the center? So this is how you conduct a detailed study. This is what you have to do. CCPILO is what, wherein you remember these words and then you think of the questions, right? And think of any other question also. Now in any other events, you can see that why coronavirus was named coronavirus, who named it, which agency is the one who names it. So you can apply the formula of W's also: who, why, and where, right, and how. All this kind of questions should come to your mind. So you need to be a very curious lawyer. So they basically want you to conduct deep research on the news, right? Let's see another illustration. Now, if you see the sample papers or other materials which are being provided by CLAT people, they have given the example of Amazon forest fires. Now, if you have to conduct a research on that, you need to know place, where was the fire, where is Amazon forest, like was there any particular place, name of the place where the fire began, or what was the reason that the fire started at the first place. Is there any international climate change policy, Indian policies related to climate change, other fires like that of Amazon or other forests like that of Amazon, right? What are the facts about Amazon, right? And then about Brazil. So this is how you need to conduct the research. Now, I give this to you as a homework or whatever, as a practice thing. That is, if you have to apply the CCPILO formula on Greta Thunberg, then who has won the Times Magazine Person of the Year Award 2019. So I'll write down 2019. I forgot to write it. So it is for 2019 that she has got the award. Now, if you have to conduct this research on this very person, then what would you see? Firstly, you will see what has she done that she got this award and various other questions. So in the comment section below, write down what are the questions that you will research about, where your research would go. Pause the video, write down your answers, and then check in the comment section below, you'll find the answer to it. Let's move on to the next slide. Step 3 is, you need to go for 1 or 2 monthly periodicals. Why? Because you need to develop a reading habit, number 1, you need to have good comprehension, and number 3, even the CLAT people have suggested that you read periodicals. So the more you read the periodicals, the better it is for you. So it is important that you go for any 1 or 2. Like, it depends how much time do you have, go for 1 or 2. Going for 1 is important. You can go for India Today, you can go for the Frontline, Outlook or Frontline. Everything Frontline again, not again. You can go for the Week of whichever magazine you think you find good, you can go for that. Now, step 4. Read 1 current affairs monthly magazine. You might be thinking, why? I'm reading the newspaper, I'm reading 1 magazine, then why I have to read this? Now, in the beginning or maybe any time, there can be times when you miss out important news from the newspaper, right? It's human mistake, anyone can make that, but these current affair magazines out here would make sure that you don't miss any. Now, there would be a lot of repetition from these. You just have to pick things that you missed out, right? So any 1 current affair magazines. Now, the tip out here is, go for 1 only, because the news is almost same. The other tip is, be consistent with 1. Go for 1, choose 1 in the beginning and read that only for entire year. Don't keep on, you know, jumping that in January you go for Pratibha Darpan, in February you go for news and events. No. Right? So choose anyone. I think Pratibha Darpan is also good, and news and events is also a good magazine. You can subscribe to them so that, you know, they deliver at your place, so that you don't have to worry. Whenever it is there at your place, you can read. Choose anyone, that's what I have told. And also another thing, if you join any coaching institute, you can also read their notes. If you find them to be really good, you can go for their news capsule or magazine, whatever there is. Then you can even avoid going for current affairs magazine, because it is one and the same thing. Right, if they have their monthly magazines related to current affairs, then you don't really have to subscribe to Pratyogita Darpan on news and events, right? Another tip out here is, if you can do this, then you can hear to DD News. That is in the evening, around 6 or 7, they have a recap of the news, the entire day's news, and there is no gossip. It's the important news that they tell. So because other news channels, if they are telling you that they'll give you 100 news, all that would be more or less gossip, but DD News has some material, so go for that. Step 5. How to make notes with GK. This is one question which a lot of people get confused with. Yes, you should make notes for GK. Number 2 is, how to make notes. Go for monthly or section-wise notes. Now, what are monthly notes is that you take a notebook or a register or diary, whatever is suitable for you. You divide it into different months, Jan, Feb, March, April. Right, or you can divide it into sections like that of international news, national news, whatever is easier for you. Don't complicate the sections very much, because the more complicated you make it, the more difficult it is to put it in a organized manner. Like when you read Pratibha Darpan or News and Events or any other current affairs magazine, they have put there, the sections are so many that you might try to divide in those many sections. Don't do that. make it very easy, make your notes very, very easy, wherein you know, write the notes, don't try and copy the headline, just write it in the way that you want to remember it. So that it, write it in easy language. You just have to pick up the facts, not their, you know, language. So just write it in your own words and note down the important things that you've researched about, right? Now, are notes important? Yes, they are very, very important. That is what I say always. Think about 1 month before CLAT, how you're going to revise GK. It is your notes. They are going to be so handy that, so make your notes by thinking that they are going to be useful then. Well, they are going to be useful always till the time you don't sit down for CLAT. Till that time, you're going to keep on revising things. Let's take a quick recap on what we have done today. Step one is reading newspaper and finding out important news and also reading the editorial section. Step two is conducting an extensive research using the CCPILO method. Step three is a monthly magazine. Step four is a monthly competitive exam current affairs magazine. And step five is to make notes. Now let's see strategies to attempt questions of GK. Don't need to memorize the passage in this section, in the GK section. You don't have to memorize the passage. You just have to pick up the main theme and you need to have the idea of the main point or main theme of the passage. They are not testing your memory. Read the entire passage. Some questions are to be answered in context of the passage. Read the questions or instructions before the. Subscribe to Loggery's YouTube channel. Hit that bell notification on. If you have a query, leave a comment down below. If you want us to make a video on any particular topic, then also leave a comment down below. If you want to chat to the instructor directly, then DM on Instagram. That is by the name I am Loggery. We have a handle. We have an Instagram handle by @IamLoggery. So you can follow us and DM us and we would be happy to solve your queries. That's it. Keep on preparing well. All the best. Take care.